All right, my dear Oliver children, and I would give you a simple idea about what is called a drama and how the term drama comes into being. And then you have to have a simple idea about the term, and I will just give you a simple idea so that you will find it so easy to study the plays. Right, and you got two plays in all of our syllabus. I'll be discussing them further in future. And prior to that, I just would like to give you a simple idea. All right. Now, when we study the term drama, when we study drama, or the we call it as play, it's better to have an idea about how the word drama derives. The word drama derives from Greek verb dran, D-R-A-N, dran. which means to perform. So drama is a story presented in dialogues form by actors on a stage before an audience, as you know that. So the genre or the literary style of drama, or I would say that style of literature. Genre means the style of literature. That includes all the plays and the profession of writing and producing and performing. Plays is generally referred to as drama. It's generally referred to as drama. It is also believed that drama originated from ancient Greek medieval Christian religious ceremonies. And ever since, it has further enhanced into many dimensions. And it was Aristotle for the first time who divided dramas into two types, which is tragedy and comedy. In fact, a play or a drama, though ancient or modern, it can be ancient or it can be modern, represent views and the emotions of the world. And also it carry a message. It might carry probably an ethical message. So that is, on the part of the dramatist, it is the duty or the responsibility of the dramatist to plan the drama accordingly. And, in a way to give a kind of an ethical message or a moral message. And then also, you also find the characters in that and speeches, dialogues and things like that. So it's very obvious that the events in a drama narrate a story. Right, the events in a drama narrate a story. So understanding the play depends on a personal interest. Understanding the play depends on a personal interest. All right, and I hope that you may just have a simple idea. And similarly, I would like to highlight also the structural elements. Now, when we study about drama or when we study about stories, even. Yeah, so there's a kind of a structural elements for that. All right, and which is related to the style of, a drama. And it's the same case with stories, I want to say that. And they are we can even call it as the pyramidal structure. It goes as a pyramid. It goes as a pyramid. And I would say the elements you need to have the exposition. Exposition means to say the introduction, and then you have some complications. You begin with some simple complication. You begin with a simple problem, and then you extend it. You take it to the level of a crisis. It goes up to the level of a crisis. And then you find the fall in action. Then also you find the fall in action. And then with the fall in action, it goes to the peak. And then it falling action goes to the peak, and then the actions fall. We call that falling action, and then end up with a resolution. And then it end up with a resolution. All right. So these simple complications, they might drag the play to the level of a conflict, and in that you find the protagonist, and then also you have antagonist. Then only it might create some issues when there are these two characters, finally. And So like the falling actions or the results or the protagonist loss of control, the protagonist loss of control, you know, is inevitable. And then only the that's going to be a kind of an effective resolution. So we also need to also go look into the message which is passed through the drama, which is passed through the play. So my dear listeners and my dear viewers, I'll be taking Twilight of Crane in my next video clip. I hope that you'll be able to you know, have a good idea, and I'll just analyze them you know, page by page and line by line, so that that could definitely help you to enhance your knowledge with regard to play. So that's all for the time being. Thank you very much, and hope to see you in my next video clip. Thank you very much.